trip number 5. Very short little trip, like our short little trailer. Cedars of Lebanon State Park. We're doing the Hidden Springs Trail. At the Cedars of Lebanon State Park, right now we're at the Limestone Sinks. And then we're gonna go off this little loop and do the longer trail. We're doing that.
Is this the 5 mile trail?
Yeah. And then we'll come back and we'll finish the Sinks Trail. Let's go.
Which way do you want to go?
This way. They fill up with water because you can tell there's mud on the leaves. Yeah. It's a cave.
Where? Oh my goodness.
Go in there.
No, you go in there.
Action shot, go in there.
You go in, I'll film.
I'll be out here filming, you go in there.
Oh my gosh, that's so weird.
And this all fills up with water. I wonder if it comes up groundwater out of there. I bet it does. Pretty cool. See, this is all muddy. And this sinkhole still has water in it. I know it's some, you know, we're near lakes. And I know that at some of the places closer to lakes, around here, the water table rises, which might be the case around here. The Cedars of Lebanon. Now, I had never been to Cedars of Lebanon State Park, and to be honest, the trail was about what I expected it was going to be. Kind of rocky, flat. They call it like scrubland. This part of the state of Tennessee is kind of like scrubland, which is why the cedar trees grow there. It's about the only thing that can grow there. Now, we did several hikes while we were here. I thought this one was probably the least good of all the hikes, but it's a pretty interesting state park. There's some caves there, and then I think there are better trails than this one, but this is the longest one. So I told Emily about, I don't know if y'all have seen the movie It, where the clown lives in the sewer, and he pulls children in and eats them. The sinkholes of Cedars of Lebanon. It's getting close to Halloween, so you might want to come out here because each sinkhole has a beast that lives within it. And if you get too close to the sinkhole, it might be like a water dragon or something. Emily doesn't believe my story, but I'm pretty sure it's true. I don't know.
I think the park rangers are going to come get you for false advertisement.
It's not false advertisement. I'm getting, this is not a paid endorsement of being murdered in a sinkhole by a water dragon. Fine. If you don't believe me, we're coming back out here tonight and you're going to sit beside a sinkhole. And when it gets really dark, you're going to walk up really close to it. Prove me wrong. You're so smart. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's scared.
At 10.
No. That might be true. What is this? They want you to go down there, Mom. Oh, wow. Go ahead, just jump in and I'll film it.
That one's actually prettier than all the other ones.
This is the one we'll come back to tonight to test the theory of the water dragons. Okay? Hi.
There's rope down there. Mom, come here.
No.
Look at this. Wow. I hate standing on this ledge because there's nothing of what's underneath us, but that's the biggest one.
Huge.
River's over there. We just hiked beside it.
It's probably hollow underneath of us.
That's what I'm thinking. Pretty cool. So back on this part of the trail, there's a lot of the trails just underwater. It rained about a week ago here, but also a lot of this is just vegetation is pushed over, so water must just churn through here. So make sure it's dry before you come.
Are you just gonna all of a sudden?
I feel like this is a dance floor and it's begging me to dance. Emily says that there's a sinkhole underneath here and that the whole thing's going to fall in with me any moment. Could happen.
So as we hike around this very pretty part of the Hidden Springs Trail, which was one of my favorite parts, we'll talk about the hike. So we actually combined two hikes on this first hike we did this on Saturday morning. We did about 5.5 miles, took about an hour and a half of actual moving time. And we did the Hidden Springs Trail, which was the longer of the two hikes. And then we did the Limestone Sinks Trail, which was pretty short. So All Trails has this one at 4.2 miles for the longer trail and almost no elevation gain. And it was pretty flat throughout. And then if you're looking for just a very short hike that has lots of, you know, sinks in it, there's actually a little cave on this part of it as well. You can go 0.5 mile and do this little hike and it's, you know, really good. And you don't have to go through the entire 4.2 mile loop, which, you know, there's some good things on that big longer loop, but there's a lot of walking. So if you just want to go on a long hike in the woods, go for it. But I think there's better trails than the original one.
Go in there, Mom.
Mm-mm.
Go in there and swim. I'll take video of it.
Nope.
She's not the most adventurous model.
Well, do you want to go in?
No, that's your job. You're like the Vanna White.
Why is it my job to swim in all the disgusting places?
Because that's what people want. They want to see people having adventures. And I have to film. I'm the director. Nobody wants to see me in a Speedo. Or do they? So this is the actual trailhead for the Hidden Springs Trail. We didn't start here. We started just a little bit further this way at the Limestone Sink. It's a little 0.5 mile loop. But you can start here too. Let's go look at this tree. Emily likes deformed trees. She's always trying to get me to take pictures of trees that are weird. I'm going to go with this one because she's right. This one is pretty cool. You want to go down in that sinkhole?
No.
But you were just in the other one.
You did make it look very easy to get in and out of it, though. Oh, this is crazy.
There's another sinkhole. I guess that's why it's called Sinkhole Loop. Yeah.
You're so smart.
Yeah, we're pretty smart. We're pretty in two. You know, we catch on to things pretty quick around here. It's like a little tent. Uh-huh. We could camp in here.
Yeah, because it might fall.
We just drove up this country road. We think there's a trail. Maybe that's where it starts.
I'm not walking through there. Not doing it. Joseph.
Cedar Forest Trail. This is our second hike of the day. We're gonna try to do three little trails right now if we can keep the daylight. And if they're worth it. So the beginning of the trail, I don't like asphalt. Emily knows when I see asphalt on a trail, I don't like it, and I don't. But you get off the asphalt. God, such an ass. It's not my asphalt that I don't like asphalt. We think they should rename this park to be Sinkholes of Lebanon. There's more sinkholes than there are cedars. A lot of the cedars are dead. I think there's some disease they get. Lots of sinkholes though. Where does all the dirt go? More sinkholes, Mom. Some of these sinkholes are so old they have giant trees growing in the bottom. Here's another one. And another one! DJ Khaled! That's Emily's joke. I stole it.
Thank you for giving me credit.
Joke creds!
So in the afternoon, we actually did three hikes in one. So we did the Cedar Forest, which is the bigger loop up at the top right. And then we did the Cedar Glade, which is the smaller loop near the near the camp office, that little circle up at the top. And then we did the much smaller Dixon Merritt Trail at the very end, which is the little tiny little loop at the end there. 3.7 miles total. My favorite trail in the park was the Cedar Forest Trail, which was the longer loop here. It had some very interesting rock formations and was just interesting. So the Cedar Forest Trail is what we're walking through right here, and you can see the rock formations. And like I said, it was my favorite trail, and it was about 2 miles, the loop we did, and then we tacked on those other two to make it a little longer for us, but great trail.
So the trail keeps going that way, but we're going to go this way and hike another trail.
No, this is where we started.
Nope. We're going to do a little trail over here behind the visitor center. Then we're going to come back and finish this trail. So that's the visitor center, the office. And we're going to go right down here. Emily's still having flashbacks. She sees grass and she's having little flashbacks from a few weeks ago when we went through some grass and got chiggers really bad. So I don't know why Emily wanted to come out here.
You're such a liar. Don't drive.
It's not even part of the trail, just like I told her.
So the Cedar Glade Trail, very short, about a half a mile, very flat, and it was pretty. Nothing to write home about, but it was pretty.
There's so many of these little rock fields where it's just rocks that have cropped up. It's pretty. And they're in such weird shapes. It's like a little bench. All right, so there is concrete, there's asphalt here, but it was a good trail.
It's just the trailhead.
Don't let the trailhead fool you. It winds up being a nice little hike. So don't be an asphalt snob like I was. Dixon Merritt Nature Trail.
So the Dixon Merritt Trail, another very short little trail. We just tacked it onto our other bigger, longer hike. Also, nothing hugely to write home about on this one either, but it was a nice little end of the day. We were totally done hiking after all the hikes we had done today. So it was dinner time after this.
Go swimming. Come on. We got to make this action-oriented. Didn't we just talk about this?
Yeah.
Okay. Water's been flowing through here. Look at all that.
Where'd we just eat?
I can't.
We just had Demos's for the second night in a row.
And there's a new rule.
And I've had rare steak two nights in a row. And Emily's not having it.
So from now on, if we go to a restaurant and you order a steak, I have to sit next to you. I can't sit across from you. Pretty hard to watch.
It was pretty good to eat.
Emily said, "Do we have to run?" No, we're not going to run. We're going to go see caves. What are they? Jackson Cave?
And Hermit
Cave.
What'd you say? Somebody lived in here?
Yeah, undetected for a while. How would you ever be able to go down in there to visit it? They would actually let people down there?
Yeah.
Like a tour.
Yeah. Let's do it. Hop the fence. Don't hop the fence. That's against the rules. We are rule followers. Especially
There's no
Emily.
Way a human could get down in there to visit that, right?
That's untrue.
It doesn't look big enough.
All right, let's go see Jackson Cave. This is the bigger of the two caves, right? Go in the air.
I wonder how far back it goes. Shine your flashlight. Give her a phone.
Pretty cool. This is a big cave.
Rose petals.
Wedding written all over.
No, I brought those for our trip here. Oh, so.
Oh, don't make them hop in the water. I didn't see all those guys.
I was just walking by and about 30 frogs jumped into this little thing. Look at them. One of them's looking at us right there. So we set out to do the Cedar Run Trail. We wound up really not doing that at all. We wound up going to Hermit Cave and Jackson Cave, and then we wound up at this little nature center, and we're kind of walking around looking at the flowers, and they're putting in some new trails around there. We wound up walking about a mile. We never actually did the entire Cedar Run Trail, and I'll explain why in just a minute.
Those are pretty. Those are pretty down.
And that's where our hike ends. That's grass, and that grass has chiggers in it. And we don't have our bug spray on. So we're not playing that game. Not today. Not today, chiggers. This is the bigger of the two caves, right?
What? What just happened?
Spider web. Spider web.